Everybody says there's plenty of videos on installing spark plugs, but specifically for the Kia K5 GT line, is a little bit hard to find. Tools that you're going to need is a 5/8 drive. I got a swivel one from AutoZone and a 10 millimeter with an extension. So first you're going to remove the turbo cap. And then you can see all the coil packs with the 10 millimeters all the way across. In general, I personally would only do one at a time. Don't try to do multiple, just so you can stay focused. I like working sequentially. So to pull these off is a little clip. You slide that back. And once it opens up like that, you can wiggle it off. Once you press down, it comes straight off easily. And then go ahead. And these are very lightly snug. Wiggled off. Notice the orientation, they're kind of at an angle, so these everything matches up. So wiggle these off. And there you go. That's how you access it. So now you just use your 5/8 and get in there and go ahead and remove gap as you need it. And do the reverse operation of what you just saw. So this has been quite an emotional event because I went to start gapping and installing these HKSs. And I'll put up a photo in a video to replace these sort of stock NGKs. And one of my friends on the K5 owner forum said, hey, those are the wrong plugs. So I'll put up the picture that kind of sparked the conversation because a friend said, hey, those are the wrong ones. Those are for the Kia Forte. And then that sent me like in a panic and a oh crap moment because again, when you're working on your car, the main thing you just want to make sure that you can afford to replace the engine or whatever you're working on because this isn't for the faint of heart. So anything you do to your car, just make sure you have the income to fix it. So I do this for fun. I'm an artist, not a mechanic. And I do it for the art and science of it because when I was poor, I did it because I had to, because we just had to keep cars running. But now that I'm older, got finished with college and everything, now I can do this for fun, just like most of you can. So the main thing is, yeah, don't go through a panic on this. I will put up different explanations of what's going on and the confusion and crush washers versus flat washers versus a flange. And all that. Plus, I'm going to do a 1,000-mile test because somebody that said don't use this said theirs became hand tight after a few miles. So we're going to do that exact same test and kind of see how that is. I tighten my plugs down to 17 foot-pounds. So we'll see if it comes loose in the next 1,000 miles. But yeah, that's all I want to show you for this part, but I'm going to show you explanations for each of the other following parts. One of the guys in the JB4 Facebook was explaining that If the educays were not seated right, then you'd find carbon coming out the edges. And so here on the screen, you can see all four cylinders in the exact same order that they are when you're facing the engine. And clearly, you can see around each bore there is carbon. And so this was because I originally was changing my plugs after about 2 hours, but still the engine felt hot, so my brain went into worry mode, and I thought I was gonna strip the aluminum heads. So that's why I just barely put any grip on it. And then when I saw the post about, hey, these are the wrong plugs, it kind of just put me in a whirlwind. But yes, following through. So yes, they do leave carbon if they're not properly seated. So what I ended up doing, long story short, is I re-gapped the stock plugs to 22, put them in, let those run for a day, and it seemed like it ran a little bit slower for me. I did a draggy run in the afternoon, and it seemed like it was the stock speed, even in map 3. So I went back to the HKSs the next day and went ahead and fixed this, installed them correctly at 17 pounds, and that's what we're going to test in 1,000 miles. So hopefully this is helpful to somebody, and can kind of dispel any myths out there. You can just order your HKSs from Berger Motorsports website. That's just the safest bet, so you get the exact ones that fit the 1.6, and yes, more to follow. So now we're going to look at whether or not these HKSs loosen up, because at the beginning of this video you saw my scare, and now I'm doing the 1,000 mile test, and I'll put on the screen the exact mileage for the scientists out there. And we're going to watch this live as I do it. So I'm going to get in here close. And he said it would be hand loose. So we're going to watch this, and we can walk through each one of these and see if any of these are hand loose. Again, I use 17 pounds of torque. Let's see if these are hand tight. And see if you can see any movement. My fingers are sliding, but they're not hand tight. So at least the first cylinder is good here that I'm in. So let's go ahead and put the coil pack in. Okay, let's check the second cylinder here. So, okay, it locked. So let's look at the top as I'm trying to hand loosen. So it's not moving any direction. Okay, that one's tight. Okay, let's see, hand tight. You can see my hand sliding off, not moving. not moving either direction. Back one is kind of annoying to get to, just because you have to really stretch. Okay, here's the final twist. Okay, it's locked on, zoomed in, turn lefty-loosey. You can see my hand sliding, but it not turning. Other side, same thing. Okay, so you guys just watched everything live with me. One thing we know about science, it's not science unless it can be repeated. And so what you see here is that if you tighten down to 17 foot pounds, you will not, these HKSs will not loosen up. If you use, tighten it up without a torque wrench and you're not measuring torque, yes, these may not hold their torque, but as you saw, it works if you use the 17 pounds as directed on the side of the box. So use 17 pounds if you don't want it to back out. If you use less than 17 pounds, it will back out like my friend said.